Hello, my name is Jordan Gebhardt. I'm a veterinarian and doctoral student at Kansas State University, and I'll be discussing a project where we set out to summarize what we know about factors contributing to post-weaning mortality in the swine industry based on the current published literature. This review was part of the Improving Pig Survivability Project, a 5-year multidisciplinary project aimed at reducing mortality in the U.S. swine industry. You can learn more about the Improving Pig Survivability Project at www.piglivability.org. Post-weaning mortality is extremely complex, and we will attempt to classify many of the known contributing factors into non-infectious or infectious causes. In other words, non-disease-related or disease-related causes. To begin with, we will discuss the non-infectious factors contributing to post-weaning mortality. Mortality results in significant and economic inefficiencies in swine production, but more importantly, is an opportunity for producers to ensure that our animals are cared for in the best way possible. Of all pigs born, only about 2/3 of them survive until market. Roughly 1/3 are lost prematurely, either during the process of birth or sometime throughout their life. If we look at when these losses occur, about 2/3 occur at birth or prior to the time of weaning, and 1/3 after the time of weaning. This indicates that birth losses and pre-weaning mortality make up a large percentage of overall losses, but post-weaning mortality still represents an area with significant room for improvement. To date, no information is available regarding the factors contributing to post-weaning mortality in the form of meta-analysis, systematic review, or comprehensive literature review. Several investigations have used data from multiple sources, but that information is best applied to the particular situations in which that information was gathered from, and really doesn't apply in a general sense across the wide industry. What this means is that there is a lot of information that we don't know about the causes and factors that influence post-weaning mortality. Therefore, the objective of this project was to describe what is known in the literature regarding post-weaning mortality. Post-weaning mortality is caused by a number of infectious and non-infectious factors. Also, there's a large number of interactions between these factors that make establishing what specifically causes mortality extremely difficult. In this video, we'll focus on the non-infectious factors that are believed to contribute to post-weaning mortality. An important component of this process was to assess how important certain factors are compared to others in their contributions to post-weaning mortality. This was a large challenge, and the information in the literature was very diverse, which made strong numeric measures very difficult. However, we wanted to categorize these factors based on their magnitude of impact. We did that by measuring how common each factor is, as well as how severe mortality related to each factor is. Three categories were created, including factors with a high, moderate, or low relative magnitude of impact. Magnitude of impact is a general indicator of how post-weaning mortality levels can be impacted by changing the factor. In general, changes made regarding the factors with a high magnitude of impact can have the greatest impact at changing post-weaning mortality. Factors associated with a high magnitude of impact include birth weight, weaning age and weight, pre-weaning management, such as colostrum management and cross-fostering, as well as season. This means that most of the non-infectious factors that have the greatest impact on post-weaning mortality actually occur prior to the time of weaning. Factors associated with a moderate magnitude of impact include acute abdominal incidence, commonly referred to as torsions, prolapse, gastric ulceration, various toxicities, genetics, various nutritional inadequacies, including gross mistakes regarding calcium to phosphorus ratio or lack of vitamin E or selenium, resource availability, and sanitation practices, among other causes. Factors associated with a low magnitude of impact include group size, transportation losses, sex, as well as various facility and environmental factors. So what does this information mean for researchers, pork producers, and the industry as a whole? There's still a great deal of information that remains unknown. Much of this is due to the fact that the impact of non-infectious causes are very dependent on the production setting and interaction with other factors. Further research is necessary to reduce the overall impact of post-weaning mortality. In the context of non-infectious causes, research and management efforts should focus on factors with a high magnitude of impact, including birth weight, pre-weaning management, as well as weaning age and weight. In our next video, we will continue the discussion about factors contributing to post-weaning mortality, with a discussion about the infectious or disease-related factors that contribute. Thank you.